In July last year, the Philippine Environment Department unveiled plans to diversify the country's water sources. It also urged Filipinos to conserve water to ensure adequate supply amid El Nino.
With the El Nino expected to peak by April this year, what are Metro Manila's water concessionaires doing to prevent a water crisis in the capital region? Joining us to discuss this is Randy Estrellado, COO of Maynilad, and not a stranger to us. Thank you so much for being here, Randy.
Hi, sir.
Thank you.
Welcome. Welcome back.
Well, I was thinking of the water business. It's certainly one of those products that's very intimate to consumers, right? They drink it. There are a lot of issues, but most people don't understand how it gets to their faucets. Can you, in 2 minutes, discuss how it gets to us?
Okay, 2 minutes. Well, for 80% of our customers, water comes from Angat Dam, which is in Bulacan, which we store water from the rains for most of the year, especially for summer. That water travels through tunnels and aqueducts to our treatment plant. In the treatment plant, using chemicals and filters and all, we clean the water with we take out the impurities and we put chlorine to disinfect, and then that's brought to a reservoir, and then pumping stations will pump it to pipes to your household, certain volume, certain pressure. So when you turn on the faucet, the water comes out.
So concessionaires take over from the treatment phase. Coming from Angat, it goes to the treatment plants. That's when concessionaires.
Yes. So from the treatment plant all the way to the meters in the house, we take care of that.
That was, by the way, less than 2 minutes. So we're talking about the water crisis. We've started talking about this last year. They say it's been there for so many years already. What is the situation now?
Well, right now we have sufficient water to provide for our needs.
Thanks to the rains.
Thanks partly to the rains, but also for all of the things that the water concessionaires have been doing over the last couple of years. Basically, for instance, in the case of Maynilad, we've added new water sources because historically we only had two treatment plants when we took over the concession in 2007. But now that number has risen to around five treatment plants. We're drawing water from Laguna Lake. We have three plants now, with a third plant operating that's drawing water from Laguna Lake that serves our customers in the south.
And you're constructing three, four more?
The third plant is just on phase one now. That will, from 50 MLD today, that will increase to 150 MLD. By the second quarter of this year. And then we're also adding around 47 MLD of modular treatment plants in Cavite.
Okay, just to clarify, when you said that there's adequate supply, we're just talking about Metro Manila, of course. It was especially the west zone that Maynilad is...
MWSS, I think this morning, that they're confident that we should be both concessionaires, Manila Water and Maynilad, should be able to handle the requirements of our people in this year, even with an El Nino.
Right, and Pagasa also said the same thing. And when you said you have additional water sources, because when you say water source, the first thing that comes to mind is Angat Dam, which is a major source of our water here in Metro Manila. And last year there was a problem with the water, and if I remember correctly, it was Senator Grace Poe who kind of said to concessionaires to be proactive in looking for other sources of water aside from Angat, so you won't be able to blame Angat when the water level dips. What are those other water sources?
I think I started my statement earlier by saying 80% of our customers get their water from Angat Dam. That other 20% essentially get it from Laguna Lake. And we started with one treatment plant in Laguna Lake. We were the first to build the plant to treat water from Laguna Lake. We started with 150 MLD. We had the second plant and raised it to 300. And we now have a third plant that's producing 50 MLD, which will also go up to 150. I think last year, in fact, that was where our problems were. We did not have excess or buffer capacity in Laguna Lake, where water comes from our customers in the south. And when we had problems last year with turbidity or algal bloom, we necessarily have to reduce production of those plants. So that resulted in service interruptions and rotational supply for our customers in the south. But now that we have this third treatment plant, we now have buffer capacity to handle that those kinds of situations. So in fact, it is something we promised last year, because we know that our customers did not have a good Christmas and New Year last year, but this year we were able to provide the necessary services to our customers.
I've been to some of those plants I visited. People don't actually realize how technical and how difficult it is. I mean, water from the lake actually going to our faucets, and there's a lot of things happening in those plants. So parang five separate processes.
There are additional processes that are needed to treat the water from the lake, because it's a lot more. The water from Angat is a lot cleaner. It's a lot cleaner. So we have to put additional processes such as like reverse osmosis. We don't have that in our Laguna Lake, in our La Mesa treatment plants.
I googled that, reverse osmosis.
Reverse osmosis? I haven't heard that since I was in college, I think.
So it's just an additional filtration to ensure that water comes out under Philippine national standards for drinking water, because there's certain parameters that have to be met so we can say that the water that is brought to the household is safe to drink.
And that requires a lot of money. Your CAPEX in 2023 to 2027 is at 163 billion. 31 billion will be spent this year. Where are you going to spend this money?
And that's coming from from almost 25.9 billion last year, which is a historical high for us. The highest we've ever spent in a single year before was 12 billion to 26 to 30. So we committed a lot of capital expenditures in this business plan that was approved a year ago. And most of that, basically for this next 5 years, 65% really is for water. So we're adding water sources, we're replacing pipes, we're adding storage capacity. But 35% will be going to new water reclamation facilities, what we used to call STPs. We now call that water reclamation facilities. This is wastewater treatment. We make sure that the water is clean before it goes back to the rivers.
Right. I remember there is some of those near Pasig River, right?
Or that's on the other side.
That's the other company.
So most of our, it goes to the.
There's one near Poblacion.
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. I got that one right.
Good. Yeah. Okay. Now I want to ask a question about your franchise. It's not going to expire until 2037.
We have a franchise that's a congressional franchise that was granted to us in 2022 that gave us a 25-year life.
But that was extended by
not yet. What rules the franchise, or interim rules that guide the franchise, is our concession agreement, and that concession agreement would have expired 2037.
Yes.
So that's shorter than the franchise, which expires in 2047. But the lawmakers understood that it didn't make sense to have that concession agreement expire before the franchise. So they authorized MWSS to extend the contract or the concession agreement to match the terms of the franchise.
So and that is going to be based on money that, just to avoid the technical terms, money that the government will be owing to you if they don't extend that franchise by 10 more years.
Yes, because we already, for the tariffs that we're charging today already assume a longer life.
So until 2047.
So that the prices that our customers will be paying will be lower.
So is and it, they extended this is, that, right?
So do we say it's a done deal?
Well, not exactly. It still has to. There's still, I think, one more process that has to go through. It has to go through the Department of Finance, because any amendments, an extension of the concession agreement is an amendment of the contract that has to be approved by the Department of Finance. But we don't see any reason why they will not agree to it.
But if that is that does not become official, how much is the government standing to possibly lose?
Not really lose, but they just have to pay and the unrecovered pay, the unrecovered portion.
Which would be how much?
I don't have the number exactly today, but it's over 100 billion. Because right now, if we end the concession today, the amount that we have not recovered from our expenditures is over 100 billion. It's already 100 billion pesos. And with the large capital expenditures that we're going to be spending in the next 5 to 7 years, that number just grows until it eventually goes down to zero by the end of the concession.
Right. And these are all part of your plan to do an IPO, right? Before, I'm not sure if it's going to be 2025 or 2026.
Well, what the franchise also requires us to go public. And we're given up to 5 years from the grant of the franchise, which was January 2022. So we have until January 2027 to list. So I think our finance people are already talking to investment bankers and really planning out when is the best time, when is the best time to do this. Of course, the market conditions have to be there, et cetera, et cetera.
And the investors that you have now are going to stay, I heard.
Yeah, yes. That's what we heard, too.
Okay, aside from, of course, the services that you offer to your customers, you're also extending, we can call it the lifeline, to those in need of financial help, most especially in paying for their water. You have this enhanced lifeline program. How does it work? Who qualifies for
that? Yeah, that's correct. Historically, we've always had a lifeline rate. So we just assume that everyone who consumes 10 cubic meters and below per month belong to the lifeline so that their tariffs are already 40% lower than our regular rates. But together with the FWSS Regulatory Office, we understood that there are other, that even those within the bandwidth of people consuming less than 10 cubic meters a month, they're still really are now qualified under the enhanced lifeline program because they're really lower income, lower income brackets. Yeah. So last November, we started this enhanced lifeline program. So if you're a member of the 4Ps, you qualify, you just have to fill up the form and submit the requirements, and their rates will be even lower than the lifeline customers.
Why does it feel like very few people are taking advantage of it? I don't understand that.
Well, maybe it's a combination of we're doing a lot of communication, but maybe we have to do more. Like today.
I want a lifeline.
Nah, it cannot be lifeline. But
you're more than about.
But we've expanded that because I think in November it was just the 4Ps that qualified. But starting this month, this year, we also introduced a new way to qualify. As long as the LGU will certify that you belong to the low income group, then with the application form, we will also consider you part of the enhanced lifeline group.
Yeah, I want to just go back very quickly to my previous question before the lifeline. If with the IPO, what would be the capital structure? Right now, there's talk that the MPIX water unit will be consolidated with Maynila, and then there's Marubeni. What would be the capital structure?
Difficult for me to answer that now, especially since it's not really something that will happen like in the next 6 months. Many things will happen, but definitely there's a lot of as you can imagine with the 160 billion in capex, we'll need a lot of funds. Right. So we'll be borrowing and we'll be raising. We need the equity that will be raised also in the IPO.
Shucks, a lot more questions. What's very exciting for you for water, the water issues, water supply in the next 10 years, things that are difficult, but we have run out of time again. But Randy, I hope you'll come back and let us go deeper into those questions as, sustainability becomes an issue even more.
Okay.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks, my pleasure.